Today let us see what is written in Bible about the story of creation, creation of this universe, creation of this earth, creation of man. The Bible starts from here, from the story of creation. In the beginning, when God created the universe, in the beginning when God created the universe, the earth was formless and desolate. The raging ocean that covered everything was engulfed in total darkness, and the power of God was moving over the water. Then God commanded, "Let there be light," and light appeared. God was pleased with what he saw. Then he separated the light from the darkness, and he named the light day and the darkness night. Evening passed and morning came. That was the first day. Then God commanded, "Let there be a dome to divide the water and to keep it in two separate places." And it was done. So God made a dome, and it separated the water under it from the water above it. He named the dome sky. Evening passed and morning came. That was the second day. Then God commanded, "Let the water below the sky come together in one place so that the land will appear." And it was done. He named the land earth, and the water which had come together he named sea. And God was pleased with what he saw. Then he commanded, "Let the earth produce all kinds of plants, those that bear grain and those that bear fruit." And it was done. So the earth produced all kinds of plants, and God was pleased with what he saw. Evening passed and morning came. That was the third day. Then God commanded, "Let lights appear in the sky to separate day from night, and to show the time when days, years, and religious festivals begin. They will shine in the sky to give light to the earth." And it was done. So God made the two larger lights, the sun to rule over the day and the moon to rule over the night. He also made the stars. He placed the lights in the sky to shine on the earth, to rule over the day and the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God was pleased with what he saw. Evening passed and morning came. That was the fourth day. Then God commanded, "Let the water be filled with many kinds of living beings."